Well, hello there. I was so angry during the last episode, or the other episode, that I just had to kind of figure out a tactic how to make it work. And yeah.
Yours is the power that topples empires, little warrior. The force of your will and the strength of your arm shall usher in a new age. With the death of the many-faced one, you have cemented your place among legends. Through the fires of Hades itself you have fought, and none shall stand in your way.
Thank you for that. Was annoying. Now, as you can see, the tree father destroys the icon for the cruel guard. I think that's his name. You have stone golem, and then you have cruel guard, and then, well, you know what.
The dragon will no longer be able to hide behind those who would protect him. Soon, he will have no choice but to face your wrath.
Yeah, really bad design in my opinion. This is one of the things I don't like about video games. They should make the boss fights interesting, not so static and so clunky. After all, it's all about dodging and hitting his legs, if you want to call it that. But because of the way the hitboxes are made and the length of your weapons, I don't think you can do it with other weapons, because that means less attacks and ultimately less damage.
Continue your quest. And know that I will be watching.
I think the tree is growing bigger and stronger, and now he has a weird head looking at me. Yeah, the tree is definitely growing in those parts that we destroyed the guardians. Okay, I get it. So we destroyed the Krell Guardian and the Pan Guardian. So that means the root is free to invade those worlds. Well, those worlds. Well, you idiot. You just sent the root inside those worlds. I have no idea where to go next. I think he was supposed to give us a hint or something. No, no hints. So what items did we get out of all those adventures? We got a keycard. The labyrinth rune. Wait, I just need to check out where to go next. Wait a minute, as soon as you get through the portal, the Krell Guard. Oh, I get it. Okay, let's do it the normal way then. So remember, the first time we actually went into the world, we saw, I think, a combination. So let's just go over here and see what it's all about. I think I can get the combination of the internet, of course, but I just want to see how you do this normally, or the decent way. And our world was actually invaded and destroyed by the trees, the ants, not the ants, the root. So I'm not sure why we are doing this right now. I think it was on the bottom floor or something. Yeah, I haven't been on Earth in such a long time. We actually have a weapon right now. Okay, let's go over here if I remember this correctly. But yeah, the game is a big backtracking adventure. And overall, I don't think like this adds much. Adds much more context to the Remnant from the Ashes story. It just, you know, adds a little extra over there, here and there. I think this was the door that was locked, so this is ward 17 or 16. Yeah, I think I was supposed to go the other way around, but okay, let's just follow this path. Looks like that storm is raging on Earth for tens of years right now. So that's kind of backtrack all the way. So we came over here with a boat, and that's the first thing you see while playing the game. And then you come over here and you have to go up, probably. Kind of like a small recap for the game, which is the ward bunker. Imagine that, all of that work and visiting all those amazing places, and you only get a bigger shield and a spear for it. This will be the final stretch of the game, level 5. And then you go up the stairs over here. Yeah, the game. Nice rain. Very nice sounds. And effects too. The game has only 5 levels, and depending on how you manage to finish them, I guess the game is about 5 hours, and I'll try to make more sense out of it. But it looks like the main purpose you are doing this is to, is because you are manipulated by the root, actually, which is weird because you are supposed to free. Anyway, it's a very long fetched story. I guess the good part is they offer you more lore. The bad part is that the story doesn't make that much sense anyway. Nice lighthouse. I hope we can go there someday. Okay, let's go up. I think we'll fight our first root soon. Even though the pen look... I mean, the pen are very formidable swordsmen. I think they should have kept the root at bay, no? Without their guardian as well. So this is the room where we find out more lore. That's the place you go and can watch these things. Wait a minute, what word is this? Okay, let's quickly check what word it is. You get this from Yasha, so I don't know. I guess you will need to kill the bosses to access the final part of the game. Ward 16, but still it doesn't really make sense, because it gives you the illusion of being able to complete the game as the way you want, but no, it's actually very linear. Yeah. Oh, he's very tough. Let's run away a little bit. I guess he is an elite after all. Come on, his attacks have barely any wind up. And I dodged it in it. Oh, this is stupid. Yeah, that's a very strong enemy. So that's the creature we saw from the other side of the observation glass. Also, I think it gave us a lot of experience. And that's how you get to the new place. Okay, so that's the combination I was looking for. I guess you can enter through the door in Krell, or through the door in here. Yeah. Yeah, you can enter through there to go and fight the boss. What a weird mechanic. I mean, I don't know. Okay, let's just go on. Yeah, not much going into this episode except for that boss fight. Okay, let's travel back and let's explore the rest of the facility and then we'll see what we have to do next. Because I don't think we can modify the location or the exit portal on the other one, on the door in here, in the mirror world. It's hard to explain, the story is not as well fought as I would have liked it to be. And it, like I said, it doesn't really make sense. You would explore so much and do so much only to hurt the planets. I mean, you are hurting basically two planets over here. Oh, I have to press it each time? Weird. Okay, let's go back. Maybe we have to find a special key. That creature is very strong, actually. Well, actually, it's as strong as the first time you meet any creature. After that, it becomes a little easier to manage. Okay, so we can't change the destination, we can just go there to kill the golem. But at this point you would have killed the golem, the stone golem anyway. Is someone alive in there? Yeah, those are the dreamers. That's the labyrinth symbol. Why is it making me look at them? All blood. Well, I guess they're giving them blood. Now, this has potential for a horror game. If we didn't have the glowing garment, the spear, and the shield with us. There's a lot of blood all over the place in here. Did I have the option to use the inventory on the other guy as well? Diagnostic. Many faces. White testing signals, okay, deceased. Not to be removed until further no test from the chair, that is. Termination failed. So what's with all the blood? I mean, let's see what we can read about this guy as well. Cyclops. Did we just kill these guys because... we might have killed these guys as the Guardians. Well, I don't really understand. Maybe the Germans became the Guardians? 12 hours to 16 hours every day. That's very helpful. Oh, we can't bring them out because they are dead. Okay. I guess I need to learn more. I need to recap my whole story of the game, but it looks like we killed those guys. Codename Labyrinth. The extra-dimensional being, formerly known as Clawbone. Okay, Clawbone, I don't remember what it's all about, but we had the mention of him in the other game. Expanding outside his mind, include the life support and diagnostic equipment. The spirit drunk port is no longer registering. Okay, so he doesn't need any more power. He's self-sufficient. His room, his equipment. It's no longer registering on the facility's grid. Cloudbone and have become, for a lack of a better term, mutually sustaining. Well, I didn't want to do that. Wait a minute, there's something wrong. Deceased? What am I supposed to do here? I might have killed him for nothing, but I don't really understand what's happening here. I pressed the button by accident. Okay, let's go back. Sorry about that, I didn't mean to. Jeez. I mean, I could have used that equipment to heal myself as well. Anyway, I think we can just use the door as a shortcut to get back to the tree entity, as it is known for now. Very weird, I expected a little more, I don't know, clarity in what to do. I think I made a mistake by killing him, but you're not sure what to do. The Dreamer is bad in the second game. And you want to kill him and you can't. And this is World 16, so this is Earth, so this is the same Dreamer you killed in the second game, but you clearly tried to kill him or kill him right now, so I don't get it. Or maybe he doesn't even need that gear to survive that medical equipment. Okay, let's go and see the tree father and Maybe he'll tell us more about this. But his code name was Labyrinth, so I'm not sure this is even the same word that you anyway. It's too many questions. If they will make something like a lore trailer or something, it will be much better for us. Otherwise, I'm just speculating and I'm tired of speculating. So where are we supposed to go right now? Oh yeah, there was another place behind the spawning stone. And this is broken, it's not even open, it's broken. He just killed us like that. He broke our defense and killed us. Okay, let's see what's behind that door and then I'll end the video. That was weird and sinister looking. I mean, you don't have to go there from what I can tell. He probably breaks open the door regardless of what you do, but still, they don't tell you this and they should have told you, go behind the door. Hey, thank you for the great camera angle. Yes, you should have sent those guys first. It would have been much better for you. I guess that's a weird looking world. the little krill are so funny. Okay, I made a mistake. You just have to dodge out of the way. They're like berserkers. Okay, if I had killed a few more, I would have leveled up. That's one. What? Where did you come from with that flamethrower? Why would you have a flamethrower in a beautiful garden like this? Oh, I know what to do here. I exactly know what to do here. Put the grain in. And wait for something. Oh, sorry. Oh, this is definitely the bird that you see on the end. Yeah, that's definitely the bird you see on the end when you're playing Remnant from the Ashes and fight the first world boss. Crown Ruby. Okay, let's play for a little longer because this was supposed to have a little more content to it, but because of all the backtracking, I kind of not did my job, so let's play a little more. Well, let me guess, it will be something related to ice. Shadowstone will drain the life force of an enemy and present it to you as a gift. Well, you know what, Sunstone? You got replaced by the dark Shadowstone. That's actually pretty good. Oh, and I like how the color changes of the crystal and also the bar. I guess that's all we had to do over here. And the krill had really nice pets. Those ravens are really spooky, and I bet they can talk. Was that always like that? Why is that thing glowing? High five or slam dunk. Why are you here? Did he just take away all of that health? Yes, he did. How much health did he take away in one hit? Okay, let's play like you do. Well, this is annoying. He does everything like me, except he does it better. Sometimes I have questions about the game. Okay, that's an interesting enemy. Let's try to kill him. Oh, that's just stupid in my opinion. It's all about the waiting game. I mean, how do you kill someone that can be... Well, the hammer, of course, but still, the game is forcing you to change the weapons, like it's saying, hey, you know that weapon you love to use and upgraded? Well, guess what? You're not using it anymore. Okay, let's kill that big guy and then we'll really end the video. Oh, wow, you're so hard to hit, so hard to dodge, oh, wow. Do I need the extra experience? Not really. Okay, let's just go for the big guy. And yeah, in case you didn't know, you can actually break the shield stands with a heavy weapon. Also, don't let him charge you. That's almost an instant kill based on the distance, probably. He has a double attack. So, too foul. That's annoying. Okay, let's try one more time. You know, I don't like thing. I'm just talking again. Well, you kill bosses, you kill huge monsters, you kill everything, and then you come across a small room with a guy with a stone sword and a stone shield, and he just clobbers you to death. That's not really how you want to design a game or play it. Oh, we are 50 years old. What? Accidentally chose a perk? What was the other choices? Stone Master. Well, I guess I'll never see the other choices because I pressed a button. Ah, silly, silly. Yeah, and this is why I don't recommend you buy the game at full price, because of things like this. Oh man, this is so fun. Okay, let's go and kill that other guy. Okay, this is so annoying. I died to that guy 2 times and I didn't even get to see the other perk choices. Oh, so great. Such a great mechanic. Look at him. mean, you're also banned for 1,000 hours. That's a weird effect. You can't. Oh, the stairs. Well, let's use the stairs for advantage. Only 1,000 experience you get for him. Only 1,000. We probably have to change the weapon again. Actually, I'll play a little more on my own. So what was he guarding? Just another room. See you next time. Bye.